was Mr. Vishesh Chandra?
Sir, he was one of the finest engineer India has ever got, and he was also involved in many infrastructural projects which were before independence and after independence.
And
sir, like a dam in Nasik, that's our biggest achievement. And for his achievements, he was also awarded the knighthood from British Empire. Yes, sir.
When is the Engineers Day?
Sir, it's on 13th September.
Why is it?
Sir, it is actually the birth date of Visveswaraya, Sir Visveswaraya.
You are basically from Gadchiroli.
I'm from Gadchiroli.
What is the name of the force? It's on the lines of Greyhound of Andhra Pradesh by CRPF for tackling the missile.
So it's C-60 in Gadchiroli. C-60.
Okay. What are the basic problems of irrigation in Maharashtra?
I'm sorry, sir.
What are the basic problems of irrigation in Maharashtra?
Irrigation. Sir, actually irrigation in Maharashtra depends upon the crop pattern, and historically irrigation in Maharashtra has been very on the downward side because projects have been named but they have not been finished with their full capacity. And sir, there is also a problem of cropping patterns. Like for sugarcane lobby in Maharashtra is very strong, so most of the irrigation has been diverted, whereas the cropping area of sugarcane is just 9%. So irrigation is one of the major cause of farmer suicides in Maharashtra, causing droughts. Some droughts in Maharashtra are like artificially induced due to policy lacunas and irrigation and other stuff. And
how can some drought be politically induced? Can you throw some light on that?
Sir, political induced means like the administrative lacunas. Like the projects have been funded and properly received, but they have not been finished to the core. Like they have not been capacitively utilized. So,
completing the stalled projects, irrigation projects,
yes,
a scheme has been launched by the Government of India. What is the name of that scheme?
Sir, let me recall. Sir, it's Pradhan Mantri Krishi Sinchai Yojana.
Krishi Sinchai?
Yes, sir.
AIBP?
Yes, sir. Accelerated Irrigated Basin Benefits Program. It was launched in 1990s.
It has identified some 100 odd projects.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
How many of them fall in Maharashtra? Can you name one or two?
I'm sorry, sir. I can't recall them.
Okay. Can you name some tributaries of Godavari?
Yes, sir. Major tributaries of Godavari are Ben Ganga, Pen Ganga, Vardha, and that's it, sir. Like they are major tributaries.
There's a dam on Vardha. Where is it situated?
I'm sorry, sir. I can't recall.
There is a dispute, interstate water dispute on Godavari. How many states are involved in it?
Sir, Godavari mainly flows through three states. Maharashtra, Andhra Pradesh, Telangana and Karnataka.
Four
states, okay, I'm sorry, it's four.
Is Chhattisgarh also part of it?
Sir, Chhattisgarh is part of the watershed region of Godavari.
So
yes, not part of dispute, yes sir.
You meditate?
Yes, sir.
Have you ever heard the term Vipassana?
Yes, sir. Vipassana, I have heard.
What is Vipassana?
Sir, Vipassana is actually the rigid practice of meditation, which whose ultimate end is the realization of non-self. It is the intrinsic part of Buddhism also, Vipassana.
Okay. Yes. What is the difference between Vipassana and Preksha Dhyana?
Sir, I'm sorry, sir. I have no idea about Preksha Dhyana.
You were third in the district in 12th board.
Yes, sir.
Don't you think that merit is not being utilized in the country? Toppers of the country, toppers of your state.
Yes, sir. Like,
and are appearing for CAPF. They're not going in research. Don't you think it's the pattern India should not follow?
Sir, merit should be recognized. Like it's not like totally wrong to not recognize the merit, because sir, end of the day it's capacity. We are capacitively utilizing our talents. And it's not just the field of academics, we can also aspire the fields of public services, and we can contribute in better ways also. In fact, the academic knowledge we've gained from the academics, we can implement it public service and have multiple spillover effect over the society.
Okay. Yes.
Thank you, sir.
President, you have said that X-660 is a special force of Maharashtra.
Yes, sir.
Last year, C-60 carried out a good operation, in which around 25 or
30 landslides
were killed.
Yes, sir.
And the report was also clear that those landslides, they were straight in a cab, and some drowsy substance was given to them, and they were That was a very clean operation in which like no 660 personnel suffered any injury.
Yes, sir.
And 39 strikes were paid. So like that is a bit like unreasonable okay, from a like common military perspective.
Okay.
So do you think like it's ethical like if like someone gives sort of such dosy substance to the person and then he's sleeping and then like the forces are going there and they are just killing them? How do you see it? Whether it is acceptable to you, considering the naturalized like movement, the way they are spreading, the way they are taking the forces?
Yes, sir. Sir, we can't like completely say that it is unethical or something, because end of the day security of our nation is the utmost priority of the forces, and sir forces are trained enough ethically, academically and combatively to you know achieve the objectives by any means, but that means should also be ethical. And sir, I think that it is a they must have taken some calculated risk considering this option, because obviously they are trained enough and they know the situations well. So end of the day, the objective was achieved, and I think it's a victory for the forces.
Let's suppose if you would be, let's suppose if you worked in the sector, you are appointed as a manager post in your district commander. Okay, what information that there's a camp in the 10 next by such okay. Your force is telling that I will get something in their pool, so that there will be that something more. Then you come and you just find them and you just kill them. That will like you will be able to kill 10 next by. What do you do?
Sir, I will first try to look at the matter from personnel's perspective. Do we have enough forces? Do we have enough resources to tackle them head on? Like instead of going some passive war techniques, we can like if we can placate them with force, then I think
you
that.
Are ready, they are 10, but they also
are equipped with arms.
Okay, they have arms. You also know that once they are ready, then guys will also get injured. But if 10 guys are like firing bullets on you, then also it's a probability that
your men
will also get injured.
Sir, but combative, sir, it's an occupational hazard. We can't eliminate this occupational hazard. Mm-hmm. So combatively, like, we have to be ready because we are trained that way also, ethically and mentally.
Sir, whether you will tell your force
that
we mix that substance in their food and we will
just
kill them.
No, sir, I will first ponder upon the other aspects which I can, like, carry on. So I will first look at the force. And first I will take...
You have 80 men with you. They are 10, they are also having weapons. So, like what level you want to do? What do you do?
Sir, then definitely I'll use the force wave only first. Because if we are 80 men, we outnumber them by 70. And I guess that is a very... We have odds on our side to win the battle. So, I find no reason that, you know, using such passive warfare.
You want to use passive warfare?
Yes, sir. Because positive war is always a better war.
But you have discussed this issue with your men, they are saying that it's better than... Like we should allow the force to mix something in their food.
Sir, but
your men are saying, they are saying that we want to fight. Like if you are getting a clean suit fight, we should unnecessarily take the danger.
Sir, I'll try to sensitize them about the matter, because it's not just about the war. It's about it's not just about the ends. It's about also means. So I will also try to placate them. I will try to sensitize them.
Sir, they also do the same thing. They also attack on us. Like when we are like going on leave, when we are going on operation. So like.
Sir, if they are
also like
okay, sir, but if they are doing it, it's unethical on their part. But it's about the ethics of us, because we are not trained and we are not manned like that. We are the forces. We are the legitimate force of our state, so we should behave legitimately. Sir, interacting with people is like knowing their perspectives better, knowing the perspective of theirs towards the world, towards their life. So, sir, it will be create a positive environment, and we can have a perspective over something in a better way and more inclusive way. So, I think interacting with people is most important, and it will also help in forces.
So, you also love swimming?
Yes, sir.
Like you swim, you have swimming. Some
conditions
also like you are just...
No, sir, actually I joined swimming like for 3 years, from 7th standard to 10th standard, and just like that, sir. I tried to enter some competitions at district level, but I was not very competent enough to play there.
Can you give some national swimmers, like what was the record of our country in swimming?
Sir, I can't recall right now, sir. I'm sorry.
No, like,
No, sir.
Some investors you want?
Sir, there's Michael Phelps. He has 9 Olympic gold medals. He's from, yes, sir. He is from United States of America.
Mm-hmm.
Yes.
Some of his records, like in what time he swims, which is stroke he
Sir, his major prowess is in butterfly stroke, but he also performs breast strokes as well. But I can't recall his time, exact time. Thank you, sir. Yes, sir. Ramabai Ranade. Sir, I can't recall, sir. I'm sorry. Yes, sir.
World Cup dekha hai na?
Yes, sir. I'm seeing World Cup.
Cricket World Cup mein team kaun si hai jo without national anthem?
Without national anthem. Sir, I have no idea, but I guess it. No, sir, I can't recall. Sir, pardon?
Grandfather of Indian athlete.
No, sir. I'm sorry. I can't recall.
What was Maharashtra's religion in Maharashtra?
Maharashtra's contribution in Bhakti movement. Sir, great Bhakti saints like Saint Ganesh.
Maharashtra's religion. Concept of Maharashtra.
Maharashtra region.
Region.
No, sir. I'm sorry. I have no idea about this.
What is the difference between LOC and LSC?
Sir, LOC is line of control, which is basically between POK and Jammu Kashmir. And LSC is line of actual control. It's between the presumed line between India and China. Like Aksai Chin, it lies in Aksai Chin only.
What is private arms group?
Private arms group. Sir, no. I'm sorry, I don't remember.
Rajat, what aspires you to join CAPF after pursuing your engineering degree?
Sir, CAPF actually doesn't just provide us combative roles, but it also provides an opportunity to serve in administrative services and public services as well. And sir, end of the day, it's about serving the nation. And sir, that aspires me more. Sir, the 5 services in CAPF like CISF and all other 4, sir, they are not just providing combative roles but also public services. So this kind of public
services,
sir, actually paramilitary forces work in synergy with civilians. So does the Central Armed Police Forces. So sir, these forces are better for combative roles as well and connect with civilians.
What is the role of CAPFs in national security?
CAPF forces like BSF, SSB, ITBP and CRPF, they are basically manning the borders majorly of the nation, and the CAPF like CISF is actually giving securities to national establishments which are of very economic importance.
What is IED?
I'm sorry, sir.
What is IED?
IED. No, sir. I'm sorry. I have no.
What is AI?
So it's artificial intelligence.
How artificial intelligence can be useful for central security agencies?
Sir, artificial intelligence is the outcome of modernity, and definitely, sir, world is moving towards artificial intelligence. The major role of artificial intelligence can be in security, like drones, and we can, sir, have a better analysis of data because we have a lot of data, and once a proper analyzed data becomes an intel, using the intel we can definitely have upper hand over the non-state insurgents or Naxalites. And sir,
don't you think artificial intelligence can be useful in mining or analyzing, assessing a lot of CCTV footage being collected by security forces and helping in real-time response to the situations?
Yes, sir, definitely. That is one of the major implementation area of artificial intelligence, and I guess India has been in the forefront of inducting AI in the forces, and we have many different things like Kavach on Pakistan border, we are implementing AI on real-time basis also.
What is this issue of controversy with the 5G technology and the equipments being provided by Huawei company?
Sir, Huawei company is been termed as a national like state-sponsored company of state China, because Huawei has been major funding from Huawei came from the state. So it the company of Huawei is accused of sharing the sensitive data like privacy issues and like the password it collects with the Chinese government. So it creates a major threat for other national governments to deal with Huawei. But sir, if we look at the historical perspective with India, 3G and 4G in India has been established by Huawei only. But it, when it comes to 5G, 5G connects more intimately with Indian population. So I think the major issue is with 5G technologies is inducting with Huawei.
Can you tell me what is fiscal deficit?
Sir, fiscal deficit is actually, sir, arithmetically it can be equated to the market borrowing, but logically it is the total expenditure of a center and minus total receipts of the center.
Last. What is the government policy, broader policy, to tackle the Naxal menace in India?
Sir, Naxal menace, the government has been inducting policies from 1970s only, from the point from where Naxalism has been instigated in India. Sir, the basic strategy was the Samadhan doctrine government gave, where it takes holistically like tackling Naxalism from root and branch. Sir, it tackles the socio-economics of the region, because socio-economics and interconnectivity are the major regions that are brewing Naxalism, and they are recruiting from the very secluded places which are very less connected with the mainstream India. So sir, the socio-economics and political reasons, we are doing better in this for tackling Naxalism.
Thank you,
sir.
One last question.
Okay, sir.
You have been seeing number of ranking by India.
Yes, sir.
Number of rankings have been started by NITI Aayog.
Yes, sir.
Like various districts are being ranked on the basis of cleanliness,
yes, sir,
water availability, and things like that. So, if in case you have been asked, you have been posted as CRPF officer, and you have been posted in now number of units, then you have been asked by the NITI Aayog to give 10 parameters on which the rankings of various commandants can be done.
Commandants, okay.
That you are the head of this commandant, how your battalion or your unit is better than the others.
Okay.
So what will be those parameters? Give a couple of them. 3-4 will be good.
Sir, first thing I will emphasize upon is the integrity. Integrity.
Okay.
Integrity as a parameter, because it is the most important factor that brews the personality trait of a person. Second thing is, sir, team association, teamwork. If the teamwork is not there, then I can't say that the forces can succeed further. Third thing is, sir, leadership quality, because it's not just the job of leader, it's about devolution of power and empowering the lower rank section so that we can create leaders out of them. And sir, fourth one will be honesty.
It was not personality oriented, it was area, government oriented.
Okay, honesty. Sir, first thing would be then work culture. How administratively the work culture is rigid, or we have discretion or not. Okay, sir. Thank you, sir. Thank you, sir.
Yeah.